Thank you for watching, and remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for your support.
Side of that storm just acting as a vacuum, sucking up all that moisture. We've got tropical moisture from Pamela. Of course, we've got your usual suspects, the moisture from the Gulf of Mexico. And Saul, all of that is going to come together and bring us that risk for flooding as we move through today, through tomorrow, even into tomorrow night. Places like Dallas, when we're talking about 3 to 5 inches of rain in a major metropolitan area, that's going to cause some problems. So we've got a flash flood watch across portions of the Hill Country of Texas, up across the Red River Valley of the South with that flood watch. Waco, you're included in that as well. You see that line of storms that we were talking about, of course, producing that tornado warning there just east of OKC. This is going to continue blasting eastward, and we'll have the latest on all of this. Stick with the Weather Channel. We've got you covered as we head through the morning.
Let's head into this green land. Green behind me, but that's not what you see. You see the airplane, because today we do see not as many travel delays, and that is good news. All of that green on the map, wonderful news if you're traveling by air. Now, does that say there's not going to be any delay at all if you get stuck under a stronger storm? No, but for the most part, we're looking at clear conditions. Pittsburgh, no travel delays in terms of weather today. That should be the story for you. MSP in Minneapolis, you might see something. Same thing in Kansas City. And to Dallas, the same thing. You might also have some, at some time, but it's not going to be the majority of your day. Just check your flight if you're heading out to travel. Now, if you're traveling along the roadways, well, you also might run into some trouble there. That 35 corridor definitely going to be wet and stormy at times. We could have some ponding on the roadways, and severe weather is likely across portions of the Hill Country of Texas. We've got abundant moisture to work with, and we're going to have showers and storms running over the same areas over and over again, and that is leading to that possibility for flash flooding for cities like Dallas, even down into San Antonio as we move through the day today. So, Jordan, it's going to be one of those days if you're traveling, you're going to have to give yourself a little bit of extra time.
Not getting winter, right. It's knocking on your door there in portions of the Western Dakotas. Now, another issue that we're going to have with this system is the abundance of moisture. We've got tropical moisture. We've got a system that's going to lend itself to rounds of heavy rain over many of the same areas. So, cities like Dallas, 3 to 5 inches of rain possible through tomorrow night could certainly lead to some flooding issues, and that's why we are seeing that risk for flash flooding being highlighted here from portions of the Hill Country of Texas, all the way up across the Red River Valley of the South, and even where you're seeing that darker green up into the Ozarks, that possibility for some flash flooding could be a big issue for cities like Dallas over the next several days. So OKC, you guys have already been rocked this morning by rough weather. Wichita Falls, this is pushing through for you. Tulsa, you've got kind of a little sprig of storms that have kind of developed out ahead of this main line, but that main line is still off to your west there.
Just in Tulsa, so you know.
Pattern with no E.
Pattern with no E.
Yeah, there you go. You know, some people are having fall with no cool temperatures. And
That's ridiculous.
I bet they're more upset about than no E. But the good news is we're going to be at least near normal, which is going to feel cool for some people, because a lot of us have been hotter than normal. Let's talk about it. Here are your temperatures for today. Pay close attention to the high today in, say, St. Louis and Nashville and New Orleans. Upper 70s there in the Big Easy. Upper 80s in the Big Easy. Upper 70s in St. Louis. Lower 80s there in Nashville and Atlanta. The country's kind of split in two. We've got the cooler air where we've got the dip in the jet stream or the trough, and where we're underneath the ridge, the dome of high pressure, we've got highs that are above average. So you see it here. We should not be in the mid 80s in Nashville tomorrow, but we will be. Now look what happens as the cooler air finally begins to filter in St. Louis. You're going from the upper 70s today to the upper 60s by tomorrow. By Friday, we're in the mid 60s in St. Louis, but the heat's still holding on in places like Jackson, Atlanta, and Raleigh. Now this front is eventually going to move its way eastward. It's going to interact with the moisture, so we are going to get some showers and storms out of this as it does move eastward. But behind it, you see it there. Cooler, drier air taking over behind the frontal boundary. That's going to be our payoff. Now, is it going to be like, oh man, it's cold? Well, maybe, because you've been well above average, so this is probably going to feel like a pretty big swing. But for most of us, we're actually just going to finally be near or just slightly below average. So for a city like, say, Nashville, where you're in the lower 80s today, mid 80s as we round out the week, by Saturday, your highs are in the mid 60s. It will be feeling a bit more fall-like. Dr. Fuss.